What up, world? It's your boy, Mr. Bringin' Maine, and we back at you with another one. Let's get into some fights. Hopefully this don't take long.
For this contest with these two fighters should be a really good matchup.
Who we got? Who we got?
Alongside me, English fighting legend Johnny Nelson.
About time too.
I do not fare good against Julio Cesar Chavez.
Sugar Ray Robinson, even though he's 180 centimeters tall, he still made 61 kilos.
This bout is scheduled for 8 rounds of boxing. Fighting out of the red corner from New York, here is one of boxing's all-time greats with 174 wins in his 201 fights. A welterweight champion of the world, a five-time middleweight champion of the world, Sugar Ray.
These two have certainly talked the talk. Now they've got to walk the walk.
Todd is one of my favorite venues. You can't get a better place to fight.
Expect. They ring the bell, and here we go. The straight right just misses. Something special.
Can you imagine walking into this tub? Walking into an arena with such non-people chanting your name? You can't even hear your opponent whispering in your ear. I've been in situations like that where it can be tiring if you haven't got your wits about you.
These punches coming from every angle. Who's winning it? Nice hook.
Perfectly nice. Skill for skill. Tap for tap. Now, this fight will say, you know what? I'm just notch above them. And so I've got to respect both of them more than nothing.
Counterfighter relies a lot on her instincts and reaction time. She got together quick to punch her opponent before he brings his spin back to block.
Counterpunch is my favorite. I couldn't have to punch it. They're the people that make the hell so peaceful.
Matt Hook misses. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one.
We're gonna jab that nigga face all the way up.
That was almost a 10-8.
We're gonna jab that nigga face all the way up.
You can't leave it up to the judges. It's up to you as the fighter. And the corner man's gotta put a firecracker on that fighter. Get out there, get the job done.
How many rounds does this fight the chin? How much life have you put in it at that?
Listen, you're not tired. You think you're tired, but you're not tired. You did so much.
You're not tired at all. You get your second win back out there. Just go out there and just box it.
We're hoping for an all-action slugfest. That round was complete domination. Let's see if we can shake things up here in this round.
My motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything worked. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you've just been doing because you've won that hands down.
Walk away from each other and then run right back into trouble. You can see a lot of finesse and skills from this guy. He has to bury his forehead in his chest and pound him up.
When you see the best of the best, you understand how hard it is. Inch and from the outside in. He
his ass up out of her. Get his ass up out of her. Get his ass up out of her.
So he's back up again, but he's got to think about his personal safety and future here, doesn't he, Johnny?
Get his ass out of her. Let me get my win. Let me get my first win of the night. Get the fuck up out of here.
What a shot. What a shot. You see shots like that in the gym. At least for once, this is on TV. Thousands around the world.
Gonna keep it going. We gonna keep it going. We gonna keep it going. What's poppin'? Big Sugar. Gonna go out, go back in. Y'all, we gotta fight.
I'm Todd Grisham, and not a bad day for a fight. We are
hope
live
it's not another
at the Empire Fight Camp. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
It's gonna be unbelievable.
The silly, the Sugar Ray. This bout is scheduled for 8 rounds of boxing. All these two fighters. And there's the bell to strike the round. Needs to put some combination work together. One punch is good, two punches better. Someone use a jab here to establish a hard. Usually you don't need a weather report for a boxing match, but we certainly do today as we fight under the sun.
The corner needs to be able to do that job. What to put in guard, what to ask about, what to give instructions in this, and what to keep on you to tell you what to do right and what to do wrong. Because that
without a doubt. He needs to go out there and think, right, you know what?
It's a good first round.
You're getting it. You're going to get.
They ring the bell, and here we go. That corner has got to find a way to get some momentum behind their fighter.
That was a tough last round. Now you got to make sure he doesn't put out there. That's what he's going to try and do. So tie him up, hold him, lean on him. Don't get drawn into the corner. Not yet. Every minute of this fight is important. Every second, every minute of this round is important. You cannot afford to lose.
We're hoping for an all-action slugfest. Safe to say that last round was a nightmare. Let's see if we can turn it around here.
They've had 1 minute to recover. Now they've got to block it. They've got to block it. They've got to come out now. And style it out. One of that foot jab. West of the jab. He smacked the top and threw the legs from back. Then, full pressure. They've got
this fight. They're gonna systematically break him down. My stamina, low as a motherfucker though.
start the round. They've got all the momentum on their side after that last round. Let's see what they do here.
Todd, my motto is, if it's not broken, why change it? An excellent last round, everything there. Wait for the reaction. And tell them, keep doing what you've just been doing, because one last round.
Nothing to do with boxing. It's how well you can take a punch to the face.
Hurt the body, push straight, hit the mind, but you're putting the foot protect and everything around that. Hurt the body, use tactics, sometimes it's all put to your boxer fire and beat them out.
Jab his face up.
This is one of those situations. You've just been hurt. You've got to get out there again. Be smart. Be sharp. Don't be a fool. Don't get something. Make you fight. Your fight. Hold him, tie him up just until your head clears again. And your legs come back again. Because if you don't, he's going to pop you off.
Going to be a fight. slugfest. Coming off that fantastic last round, let's see if he can keep his momentum going.
My motto is, he's not going to change it. An excellent last round, everything works. Wait for the reaction. Until then, keep doing what you just been doing.
Tempo show. Now, Johnny, I know it's so early on, but have you been surprised by anything you've seen?
I've seen certain fighters that can depend on just their power alone. Forget tactics. They know the second they touch you, it's done. That's where the confidence comes from.
And I just see this is winning anyway.
Skill for skill, tap for tap. It's not a match made in heaven.
Trainer needs to come in and say something special. This fighter needs to
be gonna get this, y'all.
This next run. And there's the bell to start the round. Well, they got battered last round. How do they turn their fortunes around?
Now he knows he's been hurt. He's in the pressure. He's gonna throw the kitchen sink at me. You've got to be ready for that. We'll fight fire with fire. Hold him up. Be smart. And he's going to try to bring the pressure. He knows your legs are gone. He knows you're going to be here.
Man, they wouldn't let me move for nothing.
Well, they're back up now, but they've got to be cautious. Cannot afford to trade back now, can they, Johnny?
Some fighters, when this happens, it's going to be heartbreaking. Some fighters, it makes it anger. They want to get back into the match. I don't know. What sort of character are we looking for?
Ass nigga, get the fuck up off me. I knew he was gonna do that.
So he beats the count and will continue. What bravery being shown here.
But now it's about getting back to the corner. Fresh it off.
This round can go either way. 10 seconds to go. Got knocked down in the prior round.
That is showing the fitness, that is showing the stamina, that is showing the hard work done as you. If you can get knocked down and get back up and knock your opponent down, they've got it.
Big shots from both of these fighters. Have to be careful, though. Oh, going deep into the gas tank on this one. Well, Johnny, we're a couple of rounds in. What are you seeing so far?
This game is so frustrating. We're in such a fast. Shot combination before you even let one off. That creates frustration, and that's when it gets hard.
This has been a very competitive round as we reach the midway point.
Perfectly matched, skill for skill, tap for tap. Now, this fight will say, you know what, I'm just that notch above you, and so I'm going to respect you more than happy.
I got this. It was a brawl, but I got it.
They've done it before, now they're doing it again, and look what's happened. A unanimous decision. What a way, what tactics, what a game plan.
We battling, y'all. That's two in a row. We battling, y'all. We are battling, you hear me? We are battling, we are fighting. They coming out here to be hard, take up a stab at them, making me bleed, but I'm still with it. I'ma jab these niggas' faces up.
Ladies and gentlemen, it is go time. My name is Todd Grisham. Alongside me is Johnny Nelson.
Hi, Todd. Nice to be here with you.
Okay. It's time for our tale of the tape. It's Amir King Khan tipping the scales at 140 pounds, and he's got that reach of 71 inches. And it's the...
Nice.
Sugar Ray Robinson, skilled boxers to ever lace up the gloves, inducted into the inner...
It's that good. We're up against American. He has a good record too.
Corner from Bolton, England. Here is the Olympic silver medalist, one of Britain's youngest ever professional world champion, a unified 140 pound. We've waited a long time for this fight. And there's the bell to start the round. You'd like to see more jabs. It's a new battle of lust for both of these fighters. They're willing to slow down. Oh,
That was a good round. Figuring each other out. Let me see who likes to do what.
Calling for seconds out. Unfortunately, this fighter not going to get more time to heal up and get a breather.
And keep stepping, keep moving, keep dodging this one.
They ring the bell, and here we go. Nice counter shot. A typical outside fighter, as you know, focuses on defense. Stick and move, stick and move. You look to the outside fighter, time to think. You've got to make the fighter panic. We've got to rush the fighter into doing things they don't normally do. The courage on display here is incredible. First, and then you answer in kind.
They have got great ring IQ. Counter punches are the best.
Big shots from both these fighters. Be careful though.
What?
Round. What can they do here to change the momentum?
That knockdown we just saw was a heavy knockdown. I'd be very, very surprised if he'd come out fresh. Ashes of Daisy. That's not the key.
Just when you think they're gonna have a lull in the action, we get it heated back up. Off the charts action from both of these fighters. Counter punch. It's a real trouble. That was not a good moment for him, but seems like he's out of the dark place.
Now they've got to wake up. They've got to get on the back foot, clear the head a little bit, then jump back into it again. It's all about the hustle. Get back on it.
Both fighters landing in these exchanges. He's going to have a tough job.
A very close match. He shows the skill, the discipline, the respect both fighters have for each other, because no one dare do anything like that.
Go get to him. We gonna get to his ass.
Unlike the heavier fighters, these fighters are so intelligent, it's hard to keep up. Big swing and a miss with the hook. Back and forth they go, neither fighter willing to back down.
They're so close, so close. How can you separate them? It's going to be a hard night tonight for the judges.
Here we go with these two right-footed lightweights.
Sometimes when you get nervous, something so powerful, thinking you just gotta be smarter than you. You gotta be like a little faded, a pickpocket.
Caution is being thrown to the wind. Despite what the judges' scorecards read, there are no losers in this one.
Dude, did he just fucking quit? Oh my God. This nigga quit? Oh, man. That is fucked up. I gotta come right back.